Hello everyone, welcome back to Anonymous World. Hope you all are doing well. So today is day 3 of Advent of Cyber 4. So let's see what we have today. Okay, so day 3 is OSINT. OSINT is my favorite topic. So the title is Nothing Escapes Detective MacRae. Okay, so as the elves are trying to recover the compromised website, which is santagift.shop, so elf recon MacRae is trying to figure out how it was compromised in the first place. So we need to help him in gather open source information against this website. So learning objective for today, what is OSINT, what techniques can extract useful information against a website or target using Google Docs, then extracting hidden directories through robots.txt file, name of domain owner through whois lookup, searching data from hacked databases, and acquiring sensitive information from publicly available GitHub repositories. So first of all, what is OSINT? So it is a gathering and analyzing publicly available data for intelligence purposes, which basically includes information collecting from the internet, media, mass media, journals or researcher photos or search engine or repositories, etc., etc. So the information can be accessed via the open internet. Then let's look at some OSINT techniques. So first one is Google Docs. It is also known as Google hacking or Google docking. So it involves using specialist search terms and advanced search operators to find results that are not usually displayed using regular search terms. So some examples are given here. First one is in URL. So what it does, it search for a specific text in all indexed URLs. For example, in URL hacking will fetch all URLs containing the word, that particular word hacking. Then file type will search for a particular file type like PDF, PPT, Excel, for Excel files, HTML files. Then site will search for all the indexed URL for the specific domain. Like site colon try hack me will search everything on particular website, which is tryhackme.com. Okay, so you can go through it. Also, there is a room on Google docking. You can check that out. Then second one is whois lookup. So whois database stores public domain information such as registrant, administrative building and technical contacts. Okay, you can check that out. Then the third one is robots.txt. So it is a publicly accessible file created by website administrator and intended for search engines to allow or disallow indexing of certain website URLs. So sometimes you can find restricted directories in robots.txt file which normal users are not allowed to enter. Okay, then there is breach database search. Like you must have heard about Have I Been Pwned. You can enter there your email or password and you can check if it is ever compromised, and if it has compromised, then in which hack it was compromised. Then there is searching GitHub repos. So most of the websites or almost every website has a GitHub repository. So sometimes developer mistakenly or for test purposes leave the default credentials or any important info in the repositories and forget to delete that. So it may be useful. Okay, one example is given there. So now let's proceed to our questions. So first one is, what is the name of registrar for the domain santagift.shop? Okay, so let's open whois lookup. Okay, whois.domaintools.com. Search for santagift.shop. Let's see. Okay, I am not a robot. I know I'm not a robot. Okay, so registrar information is given here, which is namecheap INC. So let's see if it works. Yeah, it was correct answer. So now let's go to the second question. Find the website source code on github.com and open the file containing sensitive credentials. Can you find the flag? So let's go to GitHub. And we need to search for Santa Gift Shop. So let's search for Santa Gift Shop. Okay. So there is one repository with Santa gift shop. Let's see if we can find something there. Again, we need to find the file for sensitive credentials. So credentials are generally stored in config.php. See, okay. So on the second line, we have our second flag. DHM OSINT works. Okay. It's S. So now, what is the name of the file containing passwords? It's config.php. What is the name of the QA server associated with this website? Let's see if it's given here. Okay, it is given here. QA.santagift.shop. Okay, now next question. What is the DB password that is being reused between the QA and prod environments? What's given here? Okay, this is the password, I think. DB password. Santa 2022. Okay, so that's it for day 3. I will see you tomorrow in day 5. Till then, keep it.